Hi friends, today let us discuss about this amazing topic of class 9th in mathematics, that is the rational numbers. So friends, before we dive into the topic, let us understand what is this word rational. What is the meaning of rational? Yes, it is agreeable to reason, reasonable or sensible. So rational numbers are sensible numbers, it has some sense in it. Okay, so let's dive into the topic. So friends, you all know the basic concepts about the number system, right? So what is the first one? Yes, it is natural numbers. So it is denoted by the letter N, as you all know. It starts from 1 and ends at infinity. Next is whole numbers. So whole numbers are denoted by the letter W. It is the set of natural numbers along with 0, right? Next is integers. Integers is denoted by the letter Z. It is the set of positive and negative numbers along with 0. So such things you already know. So here's a number line. So here are negative integers and here 0. These are positive integers. 0 is separating positive and negative integers. Okay. So you can easily plot such numbers on a number line. For example, minus 5, 2, etc., etc. So you can easily plot such numbers. But what about fractions? Right? What about fractions? For example, half. So where is half on this number line? Yes, it is exactly between 0 and 1. So here you can see this is half. Then where is 1 by 4 and 3 by 4? Yes, that's right. Here they are 1 by 4, 3 by 4. Okay, you know about such basic concepts about the number line. Okay then, let's move on. So, by this we can conclude that there is a unique number beside any number on a number line. There is a unique number. For example, there is a unique number, that is 1 by 4 beside 0. So, let us understand what are real numbers. The real numbers are the numbers which can be expressed on a number line. So, we can say that any number on a number line is a real number. Okay friends, this is a definition of real number. Okay, so here you can see the flow chart of number system. So in number system we have two parts, real numbers and imaginary numbers. In real numbers we have rational and irrational number. In rational numbers we have integers and fractions. And again in integers we have negative integers, 0 and as well as positive integers. So positive integers are natural numbers or counting numbers. Okay. So the set of 0 and positive integers are whole numbers, as you all know. So in this video we are going to focus on rational numbers. This is going to be an introduction video, friends. Okay. So now first let us see about decimals. So what are decimals? Decimals are another form of fractions, right? So there is a decimal point in it. Okay, so in decimals we have two parts. They are terminating and non-terminating decimals. Again in terminating decimals we have two parts. They are repeating and non-repeating decimals. So repeating is also called recurring decimals. Okay, so what is terminating? Terminating means to stop. Terminate means to stop. And non-terminate is to move on, continuous. Okay, so let us see examples of terminating decimals. So 1.234,
27.53,
these are all examples of terminating decimals. They come to a stop, but in non-terminating there is no stop for the decimal numbers. So here you can see the dots, it is moving on. And there are two more types in non-terminating decimals. They are repeating and non-repeating. Here in repeating, we can see a set of numbers or one number repeating in this side, in the decimal side. So here you can see 1.2, 78, 78, 78 and so on. So here 78 is repeating. So we can also write it as 1.278 bar. Or there is a bar on the 78. Okay. In the same way, there is another example, 6.3333, so on. So 6.3 bar. But in the non-terminating, non-repeating decimals, as you can see, in the examples 1.26, 46, 576. So there is no pattern here. There is no continuous, there is no same set of numbers repeating. Again here, in the second example you can see 97.46, 47, 687 and so on. We can't see any pattern here. So such decimals are known as non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. So friends, to identify rational numbers, we can use this trick. So the rational numbers must be terminating decimals or non-terminating recurring decimals. The non-terminating, non-repeating decimals are irrational numbers, friends. Okay? Okay then, let's move on. Let us understand the basic points, points to remember of rational numbers. Okay? So here's the first point. Numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. Let us understand this. P, the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, basically a fraction, where P and Q are integers. They must be integers. And Q is not equal to 0. Why Q is not equal to 0? Let us understand in the upcoming points. Okay? Let us see. The second point. P and Q are co-prime integers. What are co-prime integers? They have no common factors other than 1. Which means P by Q is in the simplest form. Okay, friends? Okay then. Let's get into the third point. We insist Q is not equal to 0 because division by 0 is not defined. So we can't have denominators as 0. Such fractions are not defined. They do not exist. Okay. Hence we insist that Q is not equal to 0. Okay. Next point. Its decimal expansion is terminating, either terminating or non-terminating recurring. As you all know, in the previous slide I have said to you, the rational numbers in the decimal expression form is either terminating or non-terminating recurring decimals. Here you can see the examples 1 by 2, 3 by 4, etc. It is denoted by the letter Q. So rational numbers are denoted by the letter Q. So friends, here a question arises. That is 0 a rational number? So what do you think, friends? Is 0 a rational number? Yes, 0 is a rational number. Let us see why. So here I have given a few examples. 0 by 1, 0 by 2. So the answer for this is 0 itself. So I have written it in the form of 0 by 1 and 0 by 2. Here you can see it is in the form of P by Q. And P and Q are integers. They are integers, of course. And Q is not equal to 0. You can see here, friends. Hence, 0 is also a rational number. I hope you understood this, friends. Yes, why 0 is a rational number? Because it can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. For example, 0 by 1, 0 by 2, etc. Here in the denominator, in the negative integers can also be placed, friends. Okay, so this is the basic introduction of rational numbers. I hope you enjoyed this video. So don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to my YouTube channel. So in the next part, we will be seeing how to plot two or more rational numbers between two rational numbers. Okay, there is a formula for that. We will be seeing how. Thank you for watching.